हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम इन द ऑनलाइन सेशन ऑफ क्लास 8 साइंस चैप्टर 9 रिप्रोडक्शन इन एनिमल्स. दिस इज द फर्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ दिस लेसन. लेट्स सी व्हाट यू विल लर्न टुडे. सो वी लर्न अबाउट रिप्रोडक्शन, द टाइप्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन, सेक्शुअल एंड असेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन, द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स, द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स, फर्टिलाइजेशन, इट्स टाइप्स एंड the development of the embryo. So let's get started with the first slide, that is reproduction. So let's first find out what is the definition for reproduction. As you can see, the name re means again and production means producing. So producing again the similar types of individuals is known as reproduction. Okay, what I said, that producing again the similar type of organisms is known as the reproduction. So it is the biological process by which the new individual organisms or the offsprings are produced from their parents, right? It is the process in which the parents produce similar new individuals. Okay, and that process is known as reproduction. As you can see here, that the cats give birth to the kittens, right? The humans give birth to small babies. Okay, so this is the process of reproduction, that the original organisms, they are producing similar new individuals, and that process is known as reproduction. Fine. So reproduction is the biological process by which the new individual organisms are produced from their parents. Now reproduction is a fundamental feature of all the known life. Every organism, whether they are plant, whether they are animals, microorganisms, humans, everyone can reproduce. Okay, reproduction is the characteristic feature of the living organisms. Each individual organism exists as the result of reproduction. Now the population is increasing. We are existing on the earth only because of this process of reproduction. Because our parents had produced us. So this is a biological process in which the parents produce new individuals which look similar to them. And the process is called as reproduction. Okay, you can see here these microorganisms, they also reproduce by different types of methods. So now moving on to the next slides, let us see what are the different types of reproduction. Okay, again I'll just call upon the definition for reproduction. It is the process in which the parents produce new individual organisms which look similar to them. So the types of reproduction. Now basically reproduction is of two types. First one is asexual reproduction and the other one is sexual reproduction, right? So now let us see what is asexual reproduction first. In asexual reproduction, only one parent is required. And in sexual reproduction, two parents are required, one male and one female. Okay, this is the basic first point of both these types of reproduction. In asexual reproduction, only one parent is required. In sexual reproduction, two parents are required. Asexual reproduction generally occur in the small microorganisms. But sexual reproduction can be seen in humans and other animals also, even in plants also. So, in asexual reproduction, no gametes are formed. Right, in later chapter you will study about what are gametes. These are some special cells. So in asexual reproduction, no gametes are produced, whereas in sexual reproduction, gametes are produced. Offsprings are genetically the same as the parents. Offsprings means the young ones, the new babies. So in asexual reproduction, these babies are genetically similar to their parents, very similar to their parents. They look similar. But in case of sexual reproduction, the new babies are genetically different from each of the parents. Okay, they look similar, but they are not exactly the same. But in asexual, they are exactly the same as their parents. But here, some variety is created. In sexual, varieties are created. The new individuals are different from their parents. Okay, different in the sense of genetic differences. Okay, they look similar. Like humans will give birth to humans only, right? But the child or the new baby will look somewhat different from the parent. Okay, so now let us move on to first sexual reproduction. So now first we will study about the sexual reproduction. In humans, we are starting in humans in the chapter. Now the type of reproduction in which the male cell fuses with the female gamete or the cell is called as the sexual reproduction. Okay, as we have seen in the earlier slide, that in sexual reproduction, two parents are required. One is male and the other one is female. So what happens in sexual reproduction? The male cell, these are the special cells which are called as gametes, right? So these gametes, one male gamete and one female gamete, or you can say one male cell and one female cell, they combine together, they fuse together. And such type of reproduction is called sexual reproduction. Now, after fusion of one male with the female cell, okay, so what is the definition for sexual reproduction? That the male cell fuses with the female cell in this type of reproduction. So after fusion means after combining the male cell with the female cell, a single cell is produced. Okay, both of these cell, one male and one female, they get fused together and they become a single cell. And that single cell is called as the zygote. The names you must have to remember. After fusion of the male cell and the female cell, a single cell is formed and that is called as the zygote, right? Now, the single cell zygote divides and redivides to develop into the new organism. So, life always starts with the single cell and this single cell is the zygote. Now, what happened to this zygote? This zygote will divide and redivide again and form new cells. And those cells will form groups, they form tissues, tissues will make, you know, organs, organs will make organ system, and finally a new organism will develop. Now, remember children that males and females have different reproductive organs. Okay, males and females have different reproductive organs. Male reproductive organ is different, female reproductive organ is different. But in humans, every cell of the body has 46 chromosomes. Right, and 46 chromosomes can be called as 23 pairs, right? Pairs, pair, one pair means two. So 46 chromosomes, if you divide it by two, it comes to 23 pairs. So you can say 46 chromosomes, or you can say 23 pairs of chromosomes are present in each human cell. Okay, so it is represented by 2n. Okay, and n means half the number of chromosomes, that is 23 in case of humans. Every animal or plant has different number of chromosomes in each of the cell. So 2n, right? 2n means 2 into 23 and it comes to 46 chromosomes. So such cells which have complete 23 pairs or 46 chromosomes, these cells are called diploid cells. Okay, di means 2. So we are representing them by 2n. N means one set of chromosomes. So 23 pairs. 23 pairs means, see, there will be one set and another set. So in one set, 23 chromosomes will be present, and in another set also 23 chromosomes will be present. So now these 23 and these 23 are in pairs with each other. Okay, so any cell which has these two sets of chromosomes, such a cell is called diploid cell. Okay, remember, each cell of your body has 46 chromosomes or 23 pairs, or you can say two sets of chromosomes. Total chromosomes are 46, but sets are two. One set has 23 chromosomes. So such cells are called diploid cells. But what happens during sexual reproduction in the reproductive organs? Okay, cells divide, reproductive organs only, not other cells of the body. So in the reproductive organs, the cells divide and they form cells which have 23 chromosomes. Fine, suppose there is a cell in the reproductive organ which has 46 chromosomes. Now this cell will divide into two and will make two cells, right? So this cell means half of the chromosomes will go in this cell, 23, and half will go in another cell. Now these cells which are formed, which have the half number of chromosomes, are called as gametes. These are called as gametes. Okay, so what are gametes? Gametes are the cell which have n number of chromosomes. N means one of the set, 23. Or you can say them, they are haploid in nature, haploid. Okay, haploid means half the number of chromosomes are present. So they are called haploid. If they have complete 23 pairs, means two sets, they are called diploid. But in the reproductive organs, the cells divide and form the cells having 23 chromosomes. One set means N. So these cells which are formed, which are having 23 chromosomes, they are haploid cells. And these haploid cells are called as gametes. In male body, the gametes which are formed, they are called male gametes. And in female body, if it is formed, it is called as female gamete. Right, I think the things are getting clear to you. Now here you can see this is the female gamete. This is the male gamete. When they fuse together, they form a single cell which is called a zygote. Okay, now this zygote, as you can say, divides and redivides. So here you can see from one cell, four different, you know, cells are formed. So now this is growing. So cells are dividing and dividing and increasing in number. And finally, the complete organism will be formed. Okay, so this is the basic, you know, knowledge about sexual reproduction. Okay, so when the male gamete fuse with the female gamete, sexual reproduction occurs. But remember, before the reproduction starts, before the sexual reproduction, in the reproductive organs, the cells divide and form haploid cells, which are called gametes. This is very important. See, now this female gamete is having 23 chromosomes. This is also having 23. So when they fuse, a single cell is formed, which is having 46 chromosomes. And this 46 is the normal chromosomal number in humans. If this division where gametes are formed is not there, if suppose they are also having 46 and 46, then what would happen? See, if this female gamete also having 46 number, if this also having 46 number, so the number becomes 92, which is an abnormal number. Because in each human cell, the normal number of chromosomes is 46. So to maintain that 46 number of chromosomes, the cells divide and form haploid cells in which the number of chromosomes reduces to half. Because then half number of chromosomes containing cells combine and make the zygote. Then only the normal number can be maintained. Fine, so gamete formation is very, very important. All the gamete cells are haploid in nature. They have half the number of chromosomes. Now, moving on to the next slide. The male reproductive organs in humans. Now, this is the structure of the male reproductive organs in humans. Right, so the male reproductive organs consist of two testes. As you can see here, these round structures, these are called the testes. So, in the male reproductive system or the organs, there are two testes present. Two sperm ducts, these tube-like structures which you can see, they are the sperm ducts. And there is a single penis in the center, you can see, right? These are the sperm ducts. Now, the testes produce the male gametes. These testes, these are the main organs where the cells divide and become, divided cell, the number of chromosome will be half, that is 23. Means gametes are formed in the testes. And these male gametes are known as sperms. Okay, the male gametes are known as sperms. Now, millions of sperms are produced in the testes. These testes will produce millions of sperms. Sperms are very small in size and consist of a head, middle piece, and a tail. You can see here the structure of a sperm. Right, so you can see there is a head part, there is a middle part, this one is the middle piece, and there is a tail also. And these sperms are very, very small in size. These are the male gametes. This is a single cell. Okay, male gamete. Gamete is a cell, and the number of chromosome in this male gamete or sperm is 23. And you can see there is a tail. Now this tail helps these sperms to move from one place to another. So when they are formed in the testis, they move with the help of the sperm duct and can come out of the body. Fine. So each sperm is a single cell and which has all the components of the cell. This is a single cell. Fine. So this is about the male reproductive organs. I repeat again, there are two testes, two sperm ducts and one penis. So, in the testes, the male gametes are formed, which are called sperms. Millions of sperms are formed and the structure of the sperms contains one head, a middle piece and a tail for movement. So, the male gametes can move from one place to another. Now, female reproductive organs in humans, right? So, in the female reproductive organs, it consists of a pair of ovaries. Now, here you can see this structure is known as ovaries. So, there are two ovaries or we can say a pair of ovaries. Then a pair of oviduct. These tube-like structures, these are oviducts. As in the males, it was sperm ducts. Here it is oviducts. And then there is a uterus. This part, right? This part which you can see is the uterus. So now let us see what are their functions. So ovaries are the main parts where the female gametes are formed. Okay, these are the parts where the cells will divide and they will make the gametes in which the number of chromosomes will be half. So female gametes which are formed in the ovaries, they are called the ova. Ova is the plural word. In singular word, it will be called as ovum. Or in simple, you can say eggs. right? Sperms in case of males and eggs or ova or ovum, singular word, in case of females. Now, every month, a single egg is released in the oviduct, right? Like in case of males, millions of sperms are produced. But in case of females, only a single egg is formed every month by one of the ovaries. Suppose in 1 month, this left ovary will release the egg. And in the another month, now this right ovary will release a egg. So only a single egg is released in the oviduct. Okay, when the egg will be released, it will move on through this oviduct. Now, uterus is the part where the baby get attached, right? So oviduct is the part where the female cell fuses with the male cell. Okay, and if the fusion occurs, then zygote will be formed and the zygote will move on to this uterus part. So uterus, and then zygote is nothing but the dividing baby. So the zygote will divide and make the baby. So you know, uterus is the part where the baby get attached. This is the part, this is the organ which is present in the females. So the baby will get attached in this uterus part. And the baby starts developing in this part of the mother's organ. Okay. And further development will occur in this uterus. Egg is also a single cell. As sperm is a single cell, egg is also a single cell. You can see the diagram of the egg here. Okay, it's a single cell having a nucleus also. Okay, so what are the main parts of female reproductive organs? There are two ovaries, two oviducts, and a uterus. Uterus is the part where the baby gets attached. And ovaries are the part which release the female gametes, eggs. And only one egg is released per month. Okay, so from the oviduct, the egg will come onto this way. Or if it is from this side's ovary, then from this oviduct, it will come and reach to this part. But here, if in this oviduct, if the female cell or the egg get fused with the male cell, then the, you know, fusion will occur and the zygote will come and get attached in the uterus part. Fine. Now, next is fertilization. Okay, so we are saying that in sexual reproduction, male cell fuses with the female cell. So this fusion, this combination, this mixing of the egg cell with one of the sperm cell. Okay, now millions of sperms are produced, but only one single sperm will fuse with the egg cell. So this fusion of egg cell and the sperm is called as fertilization. This fusion, this combination, this mixing of both the cells, one from male, one from female, is known as fertilization, right? So after fertilization, the zygote is formed and comes to the uterus part. Okay. Now, the fusion of the female gamete, you can say either you can use the word egg cell and the sperm cell, or you can say the fusion of the female gamete or and the male gamete is called as fertilization, right? So you can see here the first diagram of fertilization. This is the ovum or the egg, this round one, and these are the sperms. So from the male body, when the sperms are released into the female body, they fuse, one of the sperm will fuse with the egg. And this is known as fusion. Okay, and after fusion, you can see here that nucleus, now both are cells. So nucleus of the sperms will fuse with the nucleus of the egg. And you can see here, this is the zygote form. This is the single cell which is formed. And these are the two nuclei, two nucleus which are fusing, one from male, one from female. So they fuse together and a single cell is formed. Okay, so this is the process of fertilization. This is fertilization, and after fertilization, a single cell is formed, which is called as zygote. Okay, and because of this reason, now see, both the cells are fusing with each other. So this is the reason why the newborn babies or individuals, they have some characters from the father and some characters from the mother. So baby looks somewhat, the babies have some characteristics similar to the father and other characteristics similar to their mother, because the cells from both the parents fuse together. That's why the characters of both are inherited into the new individuals. Okay, so this is fertilization, fusion. Now next is the different types of fertilization. So see, there are two different types of fertilization. One is internal fertilization and the other one is external fertilization. Now, fertilization which occurs inside the body of the female, as we have already discussed, that in the oviduct area, the male cell fuses with the female cell. Okay, the sperms are released from the male body and they enter the female body and they fuse in the oviduct. So, if the fertilization or the fusion occurs inside the body of the female, then it is called as internal fertilization, as it occurs in humans. Okay, examples. Internal fertilization is present in humans. Cows, dogs, hens, etc. These animals all have internal fertilization, right? Means this fusion occurs inside the body of the female. But the second type of fertilization is external fertilization. Now here, this fertilization occurs outside the body of the females. That means male will also release the sperms outside the body. Females will also release the egg outside their body, and outside in water or somewhere the fusion of both the cells will occur. Generally, the aquatic animals, in aquatic animals, the external fertilization is seen. So these animals, what they do, they release their cells in the water, and in the water only the cells get fused. So it is external fertilization, right? It is not inside the female body, it is outside only. So it occurs in fishes, starfishes, frogs lay hundreds of eggs at one time. And why they lay hundreds of eggs? Because, you know, when the eggs and sperms are released in water, then the chances of fusion are very less. Okay, so they give, you know, hundreds of cells are released at a time, so that one of them must, you know, fuse with the other one. That's why a number of eggs and number of sperms are released in water. Okay, so this is external fertilization. Examples also you must remember. Now, the next is, let us see the difference between internal and external fertilization. So, internal fertilization involves the fusion of male and the female gamete inside the female body. And in external fertilization, the fusion of the male and the female gamete outside the female body. Okay. Then, in internal fertilization, the chances of survival of the offspring. See, offspring means the new babies. So, the chances of survival of the offspring are more. Because fertilization is internal, it is inside the female body, so definitely the baby has the chance of survival. The baby will definitely, you know, survive. Okay, so small number of eggs are produced. So a single egg is produced every month, like in humans. But in external, what is happening? Chances of survival of the offspring are less because the cells are released in water. So the chance of survival is very less. Therefore, a large number of eggs are produced in case of external fertilization. Whenever the fertilization has to be internal, only one egg or one or two eggs are produced. But when the fertilization is external, for the chance of survival, a large number of eggs are produced. So internal fertilization can be seen in humans, cows, hens, okay, and external fertilization can be seen in fishes, frogs, starfishes, all the aquatic animals. Now moving on to the next one, development of embryo. What is embryo, right? So now we have studied that fertilization occurs, means the male cell fuses with the female cell, or the male gamete fuses with the female gamete, or you can say the sperm fuses with the egg. So after fusion, what happens? A zygote is formed, and once the zygote is formed, it will start developing into an embryo. So first stage is zygote, single cell, and this zygote will then develop and becomes the embryo. So how it becomes, let us see. So zygote divides repeatedly. Okay, many divisions will occur in the single cell, and it will give rise to a ball of cells, right? Many cells will be formed and they will form a ball-like structure. Then cells start forming groups. Okay, cells will start coming in groups, and when they come in groups, they develop into tissues, means tissues will be formed, and then organs of the body will be formed. So now this developing structure, okay, this structure which is developing continuously, you know, dividing, repeatedly dividing and forming cells, tissues, organs, this developing structure is called as embryo, right? Zygote means the single cell formed after fusion, and embryo means the developing structure after zygote, which is, you know, completely, repeatedly dividing, that is called an embryo. Now this embryo get fixed in the walls of the uterus for further development. Okay, now when the zygote is formed in the female body, it comes and get attached to the wall of uterus of the mother. And when this embryo get attached to the walls of the uterus, then further development occurs in the uterus of the mother. Okay, then slowly and slowly body parts, you know, start developing. Eyes, hands, legs, ears of the babies, they start appearing. And this stage of the embryo, in which the body parts are identified, okay, the structure in which we can easily see the body parts of the baby, that structure is known as fetus. Okay, so we started with zygote, single cell, then it start dividing, developing structure is embryo, and in the embryo, when, you know, body parts are seen, then it is called as fetus. right? F-O-E-T-U-S, it's fetus. And when the development of fetus gets complete, okay, when the baby completely gets developed, when the fetus get completely develops, then the mother gives birth to the baby, right? So when the development gets over, mother gives birth to the baby. And the gestation period, pregnancy period in humans is 9 months. It is different in different animals. In humans, it is for 9 months. Now, you can see in the pictures here, see, these are the ovaries. They release the egg, you know. Okay, ovulation means they released the eggs. Then, there is a fusion and zygote is formed. Then the zygote travels from here. You can see it's a single cell. Then it starts dividing. Now, two cells are here. Then they form a ball of cells. Okay, so this is what now it is moving towards the uterus. Okay, and when they form a ball-like structure, now it is known as embryo. So, the embryo starts attaching to the walls of the uterus. This is the uterus part. So, it starts attaching. Here you can see that the developing embryo gets attached to the walls of uterus. Okay, this is the attachment here. And this is the balls of the cells which are formed after division. Fine. So, these are the structures. Now, we have come to the end of the video session. So today we have discussed about reproduction, the different types of reproduction. There are two types, sexual and asexual. Okay, two parents are required in sexual, one parent is required in asexual. Then male reproductive organs we studied, female reproductive organs. Fertilization is the fusion of sperms and eggs. Then how the embryo develops and get attached in the wall of the uterus of the mother. So these topics are covered today. All of you please read the lesson from your textbook, go through the diagrams as well, and stay home, stay safe, and keep learning.